Okay, so let us start this solution of this question. So I think this image is very clear why we should do this. Okay, now after that, you see, whenever you have to design a connection, that means load will be provided. Load is given 750 kN. So if you insert any bolt in this connection, suppose this is one of the bolt. Okay. And in this bolt, what will be the forces that will be acting on these bolts? That is, first one is that it will be subjected to the shear plane. Okay, the shear force will act on these bolts. Here also, if you insert one bolt on this side, then the shear plane will be there. So shear strength you have to find for each bolt, and also the bearing stress is also acting on this bolt. So you have to find the bearing strength of these bolts. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now let us start. Let us see would be the solution quickly. So these things you know, so I will not explain this again. Okay. Now thickness of the plate be from bearing consideration will be list of 10, 18, and 16. Will be there for 10 millimeter. Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
See, the main plates are of 10 millimeter. So this is 10 millimeter, this is 10 millimeter, and this is 18 millimeter. And the core plates which are used here on the top and on the bottom, these are 8 millimeter. So when you are considering the core plate, you have to consider two core plate at a time. Okay, so two core plate means 2 into 8, that means 16 millimeter. Then these main plate is 10 millimeter and this main plate is 18 millimeter. So out of this, the lesser one will govern the design, is not it? I think this is clear to you. So if the lesser one governs the design, then this thickness of the plate which will be in under consideration for the bearing strength calculation, that will be equal to 10 millimeter. Okay, because this is the lesser one out of these three value. Okay,
Yes,
clear
sir.
na?
Yes, sir.
Now the bolts will be in double shear and bearing. Is there any confusion in this? The bolt will be in double shear and bearing. You see, these bolts will be in double shear. How these will be in a double shear? Because you see, there is one shear plane, okay, one interface here, okay, and here there is one interface. So that means two shear plane will be there for each bolt. Okay, if there is two shear plane, that means you have to find the strength of the bolt in two shear, the double shear. Okay, and also you have to find the bearing. So the bolts, so we have to find the strength of the bolt in shear and bearing, and lesser one will govern the design. Okay. Is there any confusion?
No,
Any
sir.
question for you? No question. Okay. Okay. So since the two plates are to be jointed are of thickness 10 millimeter and 18 millimeter, packing plate of thickness 8 millimeter. So you see, the plates, main plates are of 18 millimeter. Here on the right side and on the left side it is 10 millimeter. So there is some gap, is not it? So that gap should be filled by some packing plate. And what will be the thickness of packing plate? That will be 18 minus 10. Simple, very simple. Okay, so 18 minus 10 is the thickness of the packing plate. Because if you do not provide the packing plate, then you cannot join these two plate by making double cover butt joint. Okay, am I right?
Yes, sir.
So packing plate will be of thickness 8 millimeter. So there should not be any confusion in this 8 millimeter. Okay. Then also, as the thickness of packing plate is more than 6 millimeter, you see in this code, packing correction for packing plates was there. Design shear capacity of the bolts carrying shear through packing plate in excess of 6 millimeter shall be decreased by a factor of beta pk. So do you remember this correction?
Yes, sir.
So whenever the thickness of packing plate is more than 6 millimeter, that then you should do the correction. Okay, and the correction is basically you have to multiply beta pk with the shear strength. What we will find the shear strength, that shear strength should be multiplied by beta pk, and beta pk will be equal to this 1 minus 0.0125 tpk. Tpk is the thickness of the thicker packing plate. So in this question, only one packing plate is used, that is of 8 millimeter. So tpk will be equal to 8 millimeter. Correct?
Yes, sir.
See, the beta pk is equal to 1 minus this, that is equal to 0.9. Now strength of bolt in double shear per pitch length. So strength of bolt, so we don't know what is the pitch length. That means if you select only one bolt, okay, that is they are finding. So you have to find only strength of only one bolt. Okay, that is strength of bolt in double shear is equal to 2. You know what? Why it is 2? Because 2 plane is there, 2 shear plane is there. Okay, it's 2 into the formula you can use. Okay, that formula, which formula? This is the formula. You see, this is the formula from IS 800, 10 plus number 10.3.3. Correct. So yes, beta sir. DSB, sorry, V DSB is equal to V NSB, NSB by gamma MB. Now you put the value of B NSB. So if you by root 3 NN into ANB plus NS into ASB. Now in this formula, you can consider one shear plane along the thread portion and one shear plane along the non-thread portion. Okay. It's up to you. Because you see, if you insert the bolt, some threaded portion will be on the lower portion. Suppose this is the head of the bolt and this most probably these shear plane will come under the non-threaded portion. Is not it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Next thing, just 1 minute. Okay, so you can imagine, you can consider one shear plate along the non-threaded portion and one shear plate along the threaded portion. But if you want more safety, then you can consider two shear plane passing through the threaded portion, because you don't know which type of bolt will be used. Some bolts, in some bolts, total length is threaded. If you see the bolts in the market, some bolts available that there is thread portion everywhere along the whole length. Okay, so you don't know which bolt will be used. So for better safety, you can use that the two shear plane will be passing through the threaded portion. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here, here you can do this number of shear plane with threaded intersection. So this portion you can consider it equal to zero. Okay, zero. And here you can put two number of shear plane, and ANB is equal to 0.78 into pi by 4 d square, and FU is equal to 400 because it's for bolt by root 3, and gamma MB is equal to 1.25 as you are using ultimate stress. Okay. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you can find this, that will be equal to 81.47 kilonewton. Assuming the strength of bolt in bearing per pitch length to be more than the shear, the number of bolts required. So as you see, in our last numerical, what we have seen that the normally the shear strength governs the design. Okay. If the, because you see, for finding the, to find the bearing strength, you need some pitch length, edge length, all those things. And initially, if you don't know the number of bolts, so how can you arrange these bolts by considering some pitch, is not it? अगर तुमको पता ही नहीं है कि कितना नंबर ऑफ बोल्ट होगा तो तुम कितने स्पेसिंग में बोल्ट को रखोगे, ये तो नहीं बोल सकते ना. तो इसीलिए कि इनिशियली बिफोर डिजाइनिंग यू विल नॉट हैव द पिच एंड एज डिस्टेंस एंड नॉर्मली द शेयर स्ट्रेंथ गवर्न द डिजाइन. दैट्स वाई यू कैन एज्यूम दैट द नंबर ऑफ बोल्ट विल डिपेंड ऑन द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ बोल्ट इन शेयर, करेक्ट?
Yes, sir.
For confusion, you can ask.
Sir, the last time बता रही होगी ना, मतलब जो shear strength आया वो factor load के divide करने से आ जाएगा number of bolts.
हाँ हाँ. तो यहाँ पे जो मिला ना हमें 81.47, इसी से हमको divide करना है total load को. और ये load क्या है? Factor load है. तो हमें factor नहीं करना है फिर से. कभी कभी ऐसा हो सकता है कि फैक्टर लोड नहीं रहेगा, उस टाइम हमें फैक्टर लोड करना है बाय मल्टीप्लाइंग 1.4.
ओके,
सो इट इज कमिंग 9.20, सो इट्स नियर अबाउट 10. यू सी नियर अबाउट 10. प्रोवाइड द बोर्ड्स इन टू रोज चेन पैटर्न एज शोन इन द फिगर. सो नाउ दे हैव चूजन सम पैटर्न फॉर द बोर्ड्स. सो इन दिस पिक्चर व्हाट यू सी, दिस इज द फ्रंट. This from the front side is not it. So if you see it from the top side, top view, then you will see the pattern. Now they have assumed that they have provided the bolts in two rows. That is chain pattern as shown in the figure 5.6. Let us see the figure. Where is 5.6? Okay. So they have not provided the top view. So this type of connection they have provided. Okay. Two number of bolts, two row of the bolt. Okay, so there is no top view. Okay, so you see what they have done. There will be two bolts, two rows of the bolt. So total 10 number of bolts is there. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Just draw the top view now, then only it will be clear to you. Suppose this is one plate, and this is another plate. And about that, some cover plate is used. Suppose this is the cover plate. This is the cover plate, and the number of bolts they have used, that is like this. So how they have managed to provide 10 bolts in this 4 row? Can anyone say? So I'm providing bolts like this, one bolt here, one bolt here, and here on this side one bolt, and here one bolt. Now I provide another line of bolts, that will be 8 number of bolt. Is not it?
Yes, sir, 8.
How they have managed to provide 10 number of bolts? Okay, let me see once. Okay, actually, I was making some mistake here. See, the bolts, the connection is this. So force is transferred in this direction. Okay, and for each connection, you need 10 number of bolts. Okay, for this side, 10 number of bolts. For this side, 10 number of bolts. Because you see, force is equal on this side, 75 kN, and on the right side, it is 75 kN. So to transfer that amount of load, you need 10 volt on this side for this connection, because you are connecting this cover plate with the right side plate, and on the left side you are connecting the main plate with the cover plate. So 10 number of bolts will be here and 10 number of bolts will be here. So if you provide two number of row, that means you should provide five number of five lines like that. How, so how can we draw that? So here one aise karke hame five number dena hai, five number of line dena. Are you getting it?
Yes sir.
समझ में आ रहा है ना?
सर,
तो मुझे ड्रॉ नहीं करना है ना, तो
सर पांच रो, सर पांच रो बनेगा, दो कॉलम बनेगा,
पांच पांच रहेगा. एग्जैक्टली, ठीक है.
यस सर.
तो इस साइड पांच रहेगा, इस साइड पांच रहेगा, तो दस हो जाएगा. ठीक है. सिमिलरली फॉर दिस साइड आल्सो पांच, फाइव बोल्ट्स विल बी हियर एंड फाइव बोल्ट्स विल बी देयर. सो दैट्स हाउ वी हैव प्रोवाइडेड 10 नंबर ऑफ बोल्ट्स. Okay, now you can find the bearing strength. When you provide five number of bolts in this connection, and before providing, before placing these bolts, you should know what will be the thickness of this cover plate, means width of the plates. Is it mentioned here? No, it's not mentioned. Na? The width of these plates are not mentioned. So you can, in that case, you can assume it is of higher width. जो तुम्हें पसंद है वो लेना है. Is it clear? Hello?
Higher width से मतलब कौन सा value?
तो ये वाला है ना width. ये जो विद है ना, दिस इज नॉट नोन. इसका लिमिटेशन कुछ नहीं है, तुम्हारे पास लिमिटेशन कुछ नहीं है, तो तुम्हें जो पसंद है वो ले लो. तो मतलब कि हमें लेना ही नहीं उतना वो अभी, क्योंकि हमें एज डिस्टेंस देखना है कि एज डिस्टेंस क्या देना है, उसके बाद पिच क्या देना है, देख के छोड़ देंगे. हमें ये विद से कोई मतलब ही नहीं है, है ना?
ओके,
इस तरह से. So see, if you provide five number of bolts in each row, okay, so you provide five number of bolts in each row like this, okay, so and two number of bolts here also again, and here one. Okay, so let us think that these will be of higher width. Okay, the plate will be of higher width. Now in this picture, so if you want to find the strength per pitch length, okay, how we can fix the pitch or the spacing of the bolts, that calculation has been done in the last lecture, na? So the strength of the net section of the plate, okay, that will give you the guideline. So what would be the pitch? Okay, now if I place that those bolts in this pitch, the pitch is not known, so what will be the number of bolts? You see, these will be the number of bolts per pitch length. So if you see, if you assume that this is one from the middle of the two bolts to the middle of this bolts, you will have how many bolts?
Two.
Here in this side one bolt will be there, so per pitch length two bolt will be there. So how can you fix the spacing? We can fix the spacing in such a manner that the strength of the net section, ये जो प्लेट होगा इसका जो नेट सेक्शन रहेगा, बिकॉज यू आर प्लेसिंग यू आर मेकिंग सम होल्स इन दोज प्लेट्स, दैट मीन्स यू आर रिड्यूसिंग द एरिया, सो द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द नेट सेक्शन इन द रप्चर, ओके, दैट शुड बी इक्वल टू द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द बोल्ट, इज नॉट इट? सो रिमेंबर द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डन दिस बिफोर.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this formula you can see TDN is the 0.9 FU by gamma M1 P minus NDH. So in this, देखो यहाँ पे जो दो red line mark किया ना parallel line. So this is basically per pitch. Okay. Because we don't know what is the pitch, so we can think that from center to center it is pitch. So we have taken this random portion of the pitch length. Okay, and in every pitch there will be two number of bolts in this line. Okay, so here, so point strength of the plate will be how much? Because strength of the plate will be strength in tension. So if you apply the tension force in the plate, so this will be under. So this section will be under the tension force. Is not it? This section, the critical, that will be the critical one, because each section is same, but this section is critical. Why? Because there is some reduction of area in this region, because there is a hole in this portion. Also this portion is equal, because there is a hole, and that is leading you the most maximum reduction in area. Okay. So you are finding the strength of the plate in the net section. Okay. So strength of plate in net section is equal to 0.9 Fu by gamma M1 P minus NDH. So P is not known, because this length of the blue line is not known, which is pitch. So P minus NDH. So how many bolts is there in each pitch? So P minus N, N is equal to 1. So DH is equal to whole diameter, that is equal to 22. Okay. Okay. So here, DH is equal to 22 millimeter, and thickness is equal to how much for plate? It is equal to 10 millimeter for the lesser one. Is not it? Because lesser one will be the governing one. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
So that is equal to 2 into this 81.47. Why it is 2 into 81.47? Because you see, for per pitch length, there are two number of bolts coming in this line. So two bolt will be resisting that, should be equalized with the tension strength of the plate. Okay. Okay. Just wait for. Okay, Akshay, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Just samajhna hai why it is happening like this. So if you equalize these two equation, and you will find a P, okay, for the pitch length, and P is coming 77.19, and that is less the minimum value of pitch is equal to 50 millimeter. There is some mistake. It should not be less than 50. So it is not less than 50. So it's okay. Hence okay. So let us provide pitch of 80 millimeter, because cannot provide 77.19. So it will be in the round figure. So 80 millimeter is the pitch. Okay.
Yes, sir.
देखो सबसे सबसे जो मतलब important है इस question में, this part is the important one. So you have to understand this part. So everyone,
sir, can you explain this part again?
Okay. Thank you. तो जस्ट वेट आई विल मेक अ बेटर पिक्चर. सी सपोज दिस इज वन प्लेट एंड अदर वन इज this plate on the right side. Okay, and we are providing the cover plate on those on top and on the bottom. So we are seeing the top, so we cannot see the bottom. Okay, so the cover plate is this. Okay, so if we provide the boards so bolt will be in this manner, one bolt. So we don't know what is the pitch length, na? So we are assuming that the pitch is like this. So this is what is the pitch? Pitch is the spacing between these two bolts. This is the spacing. Okay. And this is the pitch. So it is not known. Okay. So another bolt will be placed here. Here one other bolts, maintaining the same spacing of the bolts. Okay. We need more. Okay, suppose the plate is having a higher thickness, higher width. Okay.
Students? Yes, sir.
Because we don't know what is the width of this plate, so let us assume that this will be this width. Okay. And so what I am saying, key spacing between the each bolt is the pitch, and we don't know what is the pitch length. Similarly, dekho yahan pe aur ek line hoga bolt ka on the right side. Okay, so we have to find this pitch. How? By equalizing the strength of the net section of the plate with the strength of bolt. Okay, now strength of bolt will be governed by the strength of the bolt in shear. Because shear strength becomes the lesser one, so shear strength will be the governing one. Now क्या होगा, strength of bolt जो होगा उसके साथ हमें plate का strength same करना होगा, ताकि मतलब ये bolt और plate से एक ही साथ failure हो जाए. ऐसा ना हो जाए कि bolt से पहले plate failure हो जाए. तो इतना हमें spacing नहीं रखना है, बहुत ज्यादा close space में रखेंगे तो हमें हमारा प्लेट जो है वो पहले फेलियर हो जाएगा. तो ऐसा नहीं करना है. तो हमें कैसे वो करना है इक्वल, ताकि प्लेट और बोल्ट दोनों एक साथ फेलियर हो जाए. तो इसलिए हमें क्या करेंगे, तो प्लेट का जो स्ट्रेंथ होगा उसके साथ हम लोग बोल्ट का स्ट्रेंथ इक्वल करेंगे. तभी जाके क्या होगा, जब तुम लोड इंक्रीज करोगे तो प्लेट और बोल्ट एक ही साथ फेलियर होगा, प्लेट पहले फेलियर नहीं होगा. तो इसलिए हमें इक्वल करना है. तो इसके लिए हम क्या करेंगे, इसके लिए हम एज्यूम करेंगे कि मतलब कि पर पिच लेंथ एक सेक्शन ले लेंगे इस टोटल कनेक्शन में, है ना. पर पिच लेंथ हम लोग स्ट्रेंथ निकालेंगे. हम लोग तो पूरा क्या बोलते हैं, इसका पूरा प्लेट जो है इसका टेंशन स्ट्रेंथ नहीं निकाल सकते. तो फिर क्या करना होगा, हमें सारे बोल्ट का स्ट्रेंथ जो मतलब प्लस करना है, है ना. वो भी लेके तुम कर सकते हो अगर इच्छा है तो, ठीक है. बट जैसे कि हमें इसमें विड्थ पता नहीं है, वी कैन नॉट डू दैट, इज नॉट इट. आर यू गेटिंग इट? हम टोटल प्लेट का जो ब्लेड है टोटल ब्लेड का नेट स्ट्रेंथ निकाल सकते हैं एंड उसके साथ हमें हम लोग बोल्ट का स्ट्रेंथ इक्वल कर सकते हैं. तो बोल्ट का स्ट्रेंथ वी नो बिकॉज देयर आर 10 बोल्ट्स एंड वी नो द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ 10 बोल्ट्स बट वी कैनॉट फाइंड द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द प्लेट ओके फॉर द टोटल सेक्शन बिकॉज वी डोंट नो द विड्थ ऑफ द प्लेट दैट्स व्हाई वी शुड सिलेक्ट पिच लेंथ ओके pitch length means the spacing is you see this spacing is equal to p so what you do you will select this spacing means dekho from center of the two bolts it is p similarly from this line okay from this middle of these two bolts to the middle of these two bolts it is also pitch am I correct
Yes, sir.
Am I correct? Okay.
Yes,
so if you see, yes, bolo. So यहाँ पे भी और एक bolt तो रहेगा है ना उस side में तो उसी line में हमें कितना number of bolt मिलेगा दो bolt मिलेगा per pitch length क्योंकि जैसे कि हम लोग पूरा प्लेट का नहीं निकाल सकते क्योंकि हमें हमारे पास विड्थ दिया नहीं है तो हम लोग एक पिच सिलेक्ट किए और पर पिच लेंथ में हमारे पास दो बोल्ट है तो दो बोल्ट का हम लोग स्ट्रेंथ निकाल सकते हैं दैट इज इक्वल टू इंटू दिस सॉरी 81.447 दिस इज द टू स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ टू बोल्ट ओके नाउ विद दैट वी हैव टू इक्वलाइज दिस स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द tension strength of the plate so if we apply the tension strength tension force in these plates so if we apply the tension force in these plates so this portion each perpendicular section okay each perpendicular section will be under the tension ठीक है ना समझ लो इस बात को क्योंकि अगर हम लोग टेंशन इस तरह से अप्लाई करेंगे राइट साइड में और लेफ्ट साइड में तो परपेंडिकुलर जो सेक्शन होगा हर एक सेक्शन में टेंशन अप्लाई होगा अब कौन सा सेक्शन क्रिटिकल होगा जहां पे एरिया कम है ना तो एरिया कम किस में है दो जगह पे है एक तो ये बोल्ट जहाँ पे है इस जगह पे और एक इस जगह पे है पर पिच लेंथ है ना तो यहाँ पे है तो वी कैन फाइंड द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द प्लेट इन दिस नेट सेक्शंस कहीं एक जगह पे हमें ढूंढना है सो 0.9 इनटू एफयू बाय गामा एम1 इनटू पी माइनस एनडीएच इनटू टी ओके हेलो
यस सर
एनी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दिस
No, sir.
Any question? Okay. So that's why it is 0.9 into Fu by gamma m1 P minus NDH into T. So P is not known. So N is, you know, that is number of bolts is coming in this line. So in this net section, in this cross section, one bolt is coming, one bolt hole is coming, not bolt. So because you are focusing on the area. Of the plate that means holes will be deducted so one bolt so one is here and 22 is the hole diameter and t is the thickness of the plate now thickness of the lesser plate lesser thickness will be considered here for the calculation because lesser one will govern the design okay because lesser one will be the failing first okay so that's why it is this so you can understand then p is equal to this 77.19 so you have to put select the higher values in round up figure that will be 80 millimeter and it is not less than 50 millimeter so you see the minimum value that should be 2.5 into bolt diameter for pitch length so it is equal to 50 millimeter so you are providing 80 millimeter is it clear to you now
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now you can find the bearing strength. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So KB, you see KB is the least of these. edge distance is equal to 1.7 into hole diameter, that is 33 millimeter. Now you can select the, you can find the value of KB, and then you can find the strength of bolt in bearing for pitch level. Okay, and you can see that it is 82. So what we have assumed that shear strength of the bolt is the lesser one that is governing. So here you can see that bearing strength, it is coming 82. So it is more than the shear strength. So what we have selected, assumed, that is correct. Okay, so there is no violation in that assumption. So we can proceed. If it becomes lesser one, it bearing strength becomes lesser one. So then in that case, we have to again find the number of bolts based on this lesser value of the strength. Okay. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So okay, I'm giving you one task. You have to try this question. This question. This is generally asked in the exam. Example 5.8. Okay. Design the joint B of the roof truss as shown in the figure. The members are connected with 16 millimeter diameter bolts of grade 4.6 to the split. So this is the connection. So this is the truss member. Truss member mein kya hota hai ki bahut sara member connected rehta hai na. Aise karke, this is the connection. Now how can we connect these members? We provide this plate, gusset plate. So you see this plate, this is called gusset plate, that is provided to make the connection. Bas connection hone ke liye hame wo plate dena hai taki hum ek plate, ye wale plate ke sath iska connection kar sakte hain. So but basically these four number of structural members are there, and these are connected at this junction. So at this junction these are connected. Okay, so in steel structure this type of connection is made. Now in this question what is given? Bolt diameter is given and gusset plate thickness is given. Okay, and the figure is also given as shown in the figure. So from this figure design, you have to design joint B of the roof truss. So you see what is the joint B. This is joint B. Okay, this is joint B. You see these are the angles given here. Two angle sections, 70 70 10. Here two angle sections on the front, on the back. Yahan pe jo dikh raha hai na, yahan pe iske front mein bhi ek hai angle section aur piche bhi ek angle section hoga. Similarly here also there are sections. Okay, then the forces are given here in this question, in this each member, because these are truss members, so truss member carry only axial force. So the axial force are given in these questions. So we have to design the connection. That means you have to find the number of bolts required for this connection, for this joint. Okay, so I will suggest you to you try this question at your home. Okay, and this is very very important question because it is asked in the exam also. Okay, and if you find any problem, then just let me know, I will explain. Actually I thought I will explain this example 5.8 also today, but due to time shortage we cannot cover this 5.8. so I'll be giving it to you. Okay, you just try and let me know in the next class. If you do not let me know, then if you do not ask question, then I will think that it's clear by you. Okay.
Okay, sir.
And we will start the next chapter. So you can ask if there is any doubt from the today's lecture. And if there is no doubt, then we can end the class.
No doubt.
Okay. Devraj sir, are you here?
Hello.
Yes, so I'm making you the host.
Okay,
and I will take that attendance. Please, students, please turn on the video. And Devraj sir, I'm making you the host, and you continue the class. I'll take the attendance, and I will leave.
Recording to off.
Okay.